I started my practice way back in 1967, when there were not many issues. For example, architecture practice was so simple. One would prepare a drawing. Because you know, I started myself. I was myself alone preparing the drawing, taking to local authorities, getting the approval, preparing the working drawings, also submittals, visiting the site by myself. When a person goes through this kind of role, he understands and also values the importance of the people around you. You start respecting the client, you start respecting the contractors, even laborers. Now, today's scenario, that it is so vast, and then we ourselves, right, you know, we are dealing at a time about 50-70 jobs. So we send our assistant. So we talk very minimal with our client and we try to speak to them through our engineers or architects. This is a major change. Now the gap has widened. Earlier there never used to be the gap. The client and the architect, one to one with the discussion, and you would understand the mind of the client. Today the mind of the client, suppose it is said to my architect or interior designer and then comes to me, that gets diluted. The crux of the issue is not very clear. It's filtered, and then you know, it's a different kind of issue comes around, and then you get unnecessarily confused. The confusion is created by architects. See, every year there are about, in Mumbai alone, about 1,005 architects, they are getting degrees. There are so many architects coming up. And where is the opportunity, to be very honest? We are settled. We have got a name. Because over 50 years, you know, we have worked very hard. So we say we settle. So automatically we start getting, we are getting government contracts, semi-government, corporation contracts. But there are many architects, you know, they get frustration after graduation. Because they have not gone to the College of Architecture. There may be few. They have got aptitude and then every interest, and therefore they have picked up architecture then. But there are many, because A is going, B follows. Once you go there and then become an architect, then the issue came, and then your expectation, they go higher. Everybody feels that he has to be a practicing architect. No. According to me, that's wrong. Because as a fresher, you know nothing about your profession. You know nothing about the professional ethics. You do not know much about the construction activity as such. How to building, what are the issues? Detailing, micro detailing, contract documents, repercussions of contract. All these issues cannot be taught in the school of architecture.